Hi students, good morning. Welcome back to your Max class. So today we are going to start exercise 1.4. So I think you all know that you all are ready with your Max textbooks and classbooks. Okay students, before starting, so everyone, a very hearty welcome to all of you to my channel Be Inspired, and you are in the best part of YouTube channel, and it is a learning channel itself. And please share, like, subscribe my channel. And this is the notification bell icon. If you hit this bell icon, what will happen? You'll never miss my updates. Okay, students? So, I hope you all are ready. And I'm not going to take much more time of yours. Without getting late, we'll start. So, students, this belongs to 7th class NCERT Max textbook. And first chapter, almost all, is going to complete. This is the last exercise of our first chapter. So, after solving this, we'll go for the second chapter. Okay, students? Now, what is the first question here given for you is, evaluate each of the following. Minus 30 divided by 10. And in the previous classes, we already know about this, is that whatever the thing is given, whether addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, first you should not concentrate on whatever the number given to you. Just don't go for the symbol, not number, sorry students. Just don't consider the symbol here. So what you should do, just consider that 30 divided by 10. Okay, just you should consider, it has to come into your mind that 30 divided by 10. And we all know that 10 threes are 30. And in dividend divisor, only dividend is having a symbol. So quotient also will get. For example, dividend as well as divisor will have a symbol. Then automatically the symbol is going to cut. Okay. So 50 divided by minus 5. See here, you have in the divisor value, the value you have in the divisor, here you have the divisor has a minus symbol. So first, without considering that, we'll do the division. And here the answer will be minus 10. Of course, we all know that quotient only is going to be the answer for you. And in 9 table, you will get 9 fours are 36. So minus 36 divided by minus 9. That is the reason this minus and this minus will cancel. And we'll get only positive number. Minus 49 divided by 49. And we all know that 49 will come one time. And minus 1 because only dividend is having a symbol. Now if you observe here, you have here brackets. Minus 2 plus 1. So 2 is bigger one. That is the reason this will be changed into minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. And in 1 table 13, when will come? Yes, 13 itself. So minus 13. And you all know that if you are going to divide any number with 0, then your answer is going to be 0. And we already know that 0 does not come under positive number or negative number. Just we are not going to write any symbol for 0. Now coming to the next question, here he given in the brackets very clearly this minus 30 plus of minus 1. Minus 30 plus into minus minus 1. So both belongs to the same symbols. Minus 31 divided by minus 31. If a number is going to divide by the same number, automatically we'll get 1 is the quotient. Now we'll move on to the next question, students. So first we will solve which is there in the brackets. In 12 table when we will get 36? Yes, 12 threes are 36. And we have minus in the dividend, so that will become dividend. And 3 divided by 3 is 1 and minus 1. So here we have to solve this. First of all, minus 6 is bigger one, so the answer will be subtraction. And you will get minus 1 here divided by. And here also minus 2 is bigger one. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Nothing but 2 minus 1. Minus 1 divided by 1. 1 table 1 when will come? 1 1s are 1. And here both are having the negative symbol. So that is the reason the symbol will strike off and we'll get positive number. Right? Now we'll move on to the next question, students. Verify that A divided by B plus C is not equal to A divided by B plus A divided by C for each of the following values of A, B and C. Okay, so here what he is asking for you is he given some values of A, B, C. And he is asking that to write, to check whether the values are going to be same or not. for the given equation. So what is the equation here? Now for this, we already know that before is equal to, we have a value called LHS, and after is equal to, we will call that as RHS, nothing but left hand side and right hand side. So first we will go left hand side. This is called left hand side. Excuse me, students. Now in place of A, B, C, what is the value C given? That we will substitute. So in place of A, 12 divided by, in place of B, minus 4 plus, and C value is 2. Now first we are going to solve the brackets. So 4 and 2, automatically 4 is bigger one, and you have negative symbol, so that is the reason we will go for subtraction. 4 minus 2 is 2, and minus value is big, so that is the reason minus 2. In 2 table, 2 6 are 12, and we have divisor is having minus symbol, so that is the reason we will write here. And now coming to right hand side, A divided by B plus A divided by C. So what is the value of A here? 12 divided by minus 4 plus 12 divided by, sorry, 2. Now in 4 table, when we will get 12, 4 3s are 12, and divisor is having a symbol minus, so that is the reason 2 6s are 12. Automatically 6 is bigger one, 6 minus 3 is 3, and here we got 3 and here we got minus 6. Both are not equal, so what he said is correct. And here I should write, therefore LHS not equal to RHS. Now coming to this question, A divided by B plus C is not equal to A divided by B plus A divided by C. Now we will write here LHS, same like the previous question only. So the value of A is here minus 10 divided by, the value of B is 1 and C is also 1. Minus 10 divided by, first we are going to solve brackets based on Bodman's rule. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So 2 5s are 10, and minus is there for dividend. And now coming to the RHS. A divided by B plus A divided by C. So what is the value of A here? Minus 10 divided by 1 plus, the value of A is minus 10 divided by C is 1. So minus 10 divided by 1 is nothing but minus 10, because if you are going to do division with 1, we'll get the same number, and here also we'll get minus 10, and both are having same symbols. We can write the answer, we can go for addition. 10 plus 10 is 20, and minus 5 is not equal to minus 20. So that means whatever he said in the question is correct. This is the conclusion over here. Now coming to this question, fill in the blanks. Okay students, now in this fill in the blanks, some number 369 divided by a number will give you 369. How can we find this? If a number is going to divide it by 1, then only the quotient, whatever number you are going to divide, the same number will come here, right? Now in the same way, minus 75 divided by some number is equal to minus 1. So what is the answer we'll get? If a number divided by the same number, then only we'll get 1. And here we have minus, and here also you have minus. That means this should not be a minus, because when we'll get minus symbol, either in dividend or in divisor, if we have a negative, if we have minus symbol, then only we will get. Okay students, so that is the reason here I'm not going to keep minus symbol. Now based on the same divisibility rule, sorry, based on the same division properties, here also we'll follow. Minus 206 divided by some number will give you 1. So when we'll get quotient 1, if a number is going to divide it by the same number, then only we'll get 1, right? Now minus, and here you have only plus. So that means both are should be the same number, right? Now minus 87 divided by some number will give you 87. When we'll get 87? Yes, when a number is going to divide it by 1, then we'll get the same number. And here you have plus 87, that means we have two negative numbers. And some number divided by 1 is equal to minus 87. So it is same like D. We have only one negative number, that is the reason we have only one negative symbol. That is the reason we'll keep here. Okay, now we'll move on to this. Dash divided by 48 is equal to minus 1. So with what number if you'll divide, you'll get 1? Yes, the same number, 48. But here, minus 1, so that is the reason, minus 48. Because here, minus sign not there. Okay? Now, 20 divided by some number will give you 2. When you'll get 2, so simple, you have to go for 20 divided by 2. 2 ones are 2 and 0. 2 zeros are 0. So the answer is 10. And here, answer quotient minus. So that is the reason here also minus, because here minus is not there. Now some number divided by 4 is equal to minus 3. When something divided by 4 is equal to minus 3, then if it will go to the opposite side, the division symbol will change into multiplication. So that number is equal to minus 3 into 4, nothing but minus 12. So the answer here is minus 12. Okay, students? Now we'll move on to the next question. Write 5 pairs of integers AB such that A divided by B is equal to minus 3. One pair is 6 minus 2 because 6 divided by minus 2 is 3. Okay, so we are going to write 5 pairs based on this question. Okay, so that will come when you will find factors of 3, right? So what are the factors of 3 we will see, and that too in division it should come. One, threes are 3, okay. Not factors, this one will come like, he should get minus 3. Okay, so any table we can go for 9 divided by 3 and minus 9 I'll go. Then I'll get minus 3. Because 3 threes are 9. In the same way, you can go for minus 12 divided by 3 is equal to minus 3. Okay, if you are thinking that 3 should not come here, you can go for any other number like minus 3 divided by 1 is equal to minus 3. 3 pairs we completed, like that we'll go for next one more pair. We can go for one more bit like, minus 15 divided by 5 is equal to minus 3, and minus 18 divided by 6 is equal to minus 3, and you can go for any other question like, 7 threes are 21, right? So minus 21 divided by 7 is equal to minus 3. 9 threes are 27. Minus 27 divided by 9 is equal to minus 3. Of course, you can keep this plus 9, plus 27 minus 9. Like table, how many times when you'll get 3 times like that? For example, and one more like 30 divided by minus 10 is equal to 3. Sorry, minus 3. Like this, you can go for so many questions. Okay, students? Like any table, when you'll get 3, that you can go for. For example, I will just say one thing. 12 into 3 is equal to 36, right? So just remove this 36 divided by minus 12 and you'll get the quotient automatically 3. In that way you can go, you'll have so many tables, starting from one table to tell how many tables you want to write, you can write, you can go for that. Okay, I hope you all understand this. I'll meet you tomorrow's class. Thank you, students.